cigarettes, we would have a better America. Better men and women. And not so much juvenile delinquency.
There would be, you know, gestures like when I would say Jesus, my arms would have to go out, to when I would say the devil, I would go forward. And she had this incredible set of signals. And they were like, if she would say, oh Jesus, if I was going too slow. Or if she said, glory to God, you know, that meant you better speed up and go a little bit faster. Then later on, they came up with more signals, like praise God meant, you know, you've got the people where you need them. You better take an offering and raise some money.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Lift up your hands and worship the Lord. Praise Him tonight. Hallelujah! Oh, God is so real tonight. If you can't feel the Holy Ghost tonight, man, you're dead and you don't know it. So why don't you praise Him? Why don't you call upon His name? Why don't you worship the Lord tonight? Oh, lift up your hands and praise Him. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you. Right now, Jesus. Say Jesus. Say it again, Jesus. In the name of Jesus, brother. Be loose. Be set free right now. That's right. Say Jesus. Just say Jesus.
There's the experience where you say you're saved, then there's the fire baptism when you get the Holy Ghost, and that's the tongues thing. And they love to work people over. You've got to, like, shoot in on this. When you see people gathering around people and start laying hands on and praying with someone, you've got to, like, come in with the camera too. It's very important, because they'll be laying hands on someone and the poor person will be saying, you know, thank you, Jesus. Now, this is a person that's already saved, but they're getting the baptism, and someone will be standing there going, you know, and the poor person will be standing there and they're not saying anything. Then after a while, about four or five more will gather around and they'll start doing the same thing, you know, come on, speak it out, till all of a sudden the person will, you know, get so over overwhelmed by the thing that they start going, you know, and the next thing, you know, oh, that's it, you've got it, like they feel good, we got another one, you know. Then they'll go on to the next person.
I said, are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Thank you, Jesus. Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Jesus is so good to me tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I praise the Lord. Oh, glory, glory, hallelujah. I feel good in my soul. Praise the Lord. Oh, sure isn't as heavy as it used to be, though, in the old days. Wow.
There's one guy that gets into it so heavy that he prophesies, and he told me how he did. He sat right, I mean, he looked right across the table back and forth at me. And he told me how, you know, how he confiscates money. He says he's on this station, it's over 40 states, and he'll go on there and he'll get on the radio and he'll say, I know that listening to my little voice tonight, that there's some lady out there and you've got $10 put away in a cookie jar. Now God spoke to my heart and told me to go and tell you to get that $10 and get it in the mail and send it to me, and God will bless you. God will give you a reward such as you have never known before. And then he comes back to me and he tells me, he says, if you're on the radio and you're going over 40 states and you're on at prime time, you've got thousands of people listening, the chances are that there are at least 200 or 300 little old ladies who've got a $10 bill in a cookie jar. And so if you even get, you know, if a couple hundred go over and get it and send it to you, that's $2,000 that you've made just like that. And so, you know, if you're going to get into big time religion, this is the games you've got to play, things like that. It's a, you go into it as a business and you work it as a business, you know. Going to do something for you. Then I'll turn around to the crowd, and I'll say, everyone, do you believe it? And you know, everyone, say yes, you know. I said, that's not enough. If there's no faith here tonight, I can't do anything. You've got to believe it. And I go, do you believe it? And then by this time, the crowds go, yes. Well, and I'll say, sister, as I lay my hands on you, it's going to happen. By this time, you're just like this, you know, because I do a whole thing on you. Then, you know, I sort of like get down to, now I'm going to pray the prayer, and everyone bow your heads. And all of a sudden, they go, in the name of Jesus. And I mean, by this time, the shock doesn't get you.
How do you feel?
Once you get one or two that really come off and say, yeah, I really felt that, you know, I had a bad back or a bad leg, then there's a host of them say, oh, yeah, I feel better too, because like 90% of it's psychosomatic.
I feel better. Yeah.